Good morning to all. My name is Selvan Nagarathinam. I am an IPS officer of 2014 batch belonging to Tamil Nadu cadre. Currently, I am serving as Assistant Superintendent of Police, Tuticorin Town, Tuticorin District. My motivation to join IPS is the passion for the uniform. I have always loved uniform, and it has been one constantly motivating factor throughout my life. And above all about that, the most important, another important thing in my career as an IPS officer is I wanted to serve the public, and I wanted to provide justice to the real needy and the downtrodden sections of the society. IPS as a career gives you a lot of opportunities to serve the public in different ways, in providing support and care to the victims, also to bring the culprits to the book, and also provide a fair and transparent criminal justice system to the society, which is the most need of the hour. The typical day of an IPS officer depends upon the post he is serving in. Currently, I am serving in law and order. So as such, there is no standard routine or a standard pattern of working in my life. But yes, it consists of office hours, field visits, formal and informal and surprise inspection and visit to my police stations. Also, maybe visiting of crime scenes, writing reports, and also reporting to my juniors and taking reports from my juniors and reporting to my seniors. And also, mostly, yes, the most important thing is there will be a lot of public coming and meeting us. They will be coming with different problems and their issues. So visiting the public is also one of the most important part of the day. And all about that, I always try to go for surprise checks wherever we get some kind of information. So that as such, in law and order, there is no typical pattern of or routine of the functioning. But yes, there are standard works which has to be carried out in every day. For example, there is like something like a daily report which you have to give to the senior officer. So something like that are standard, but unless and until there is no emergency or any other issues cropping up in the place of where I work, the remains the same. Work-life balance for active police officer who works in law and order is very difficult. Sometimes your days are very long, taxing, and it burns out you very much. But yes, one has to find time to motivate himself to do different things. And also, I believe in investing time in one's own personal growth and development. For example, I read at least half an hour a day, either through books or maybe e-material, whatever is available. And I work out, and I do some of my hobbies like maybe listening to music or watching movies. So the work-life balance is with you. It is what you decide for yourself and how you want to prioritize things with your work and your life, your passion, your hobbies or interest or whatever you may call it. But yes, certainly if one has the will to do it, certainly he can have a perfect work-life balance. Though there are challenges, but certainly there are ways to go about it. Training of an IPS officer is the best thing which can happen to any police aspirant. Training, as said by many, is the best part of your career and best part of your life. The training is very tough. It's both mentally and physically a biggest challenge in a normal person's life, because he is entering into a new era of policing. So essentially, police training prepares you to be a good police officer with essential qualities which is needed for the service to the public, and also carrying out your day-to-day duties in a very fair and transparent manner. So police training also develops your character, your officer-like qualities, and your other inherent qualities which is needed to be not only as an officer but also a good human being. So as a common myth is there, police training is not only about physical toughness or physical challenges. It's more of a molding of a normal person, as what Michelangelo says, and it has been very evidently quoted in many places in our National Police Academy. There is a beautiful sculpture in every stone. The artist, his capabilities and his finesse lies in bringing out it. Likewise, the efficiency of the police training is based upon bringing the essential qualities of an officer and making a gentleman officer out of a normal person, and carving out his total growth and development and his personality in the best manner. Policing, as I said, is a very unique, very challenging and a very mundane work. It doesn't have routine functions like other departments. It's day-to-day basis. You get new work and new challenges. It can be a murder case or it can be a robbery, etc. So there is no set pattern of work like other departments of government. And every post in police and every place is very different and very unique. Working in Northeast is essentially a different challenge. The work is more like a paramilitary or an army officer kind of work. It involves operations, jungle warfare techniques, going for long convoys, etc. But in a place like Tamil Nadu, it's very, very different. Here the policing is more related to crime and day-to-day law and order issues and other normal civilian work. So essentially the difference between working in a northeastern state like Manipur and Tamil Nadu is that the challenge what we face may not be different, but the work is quite different, because the work in northeast is more unilateral and it's more focused on insurgency and related problems. But in working style in Tamil Nadu gives you a lot of opportunities and a lot of varied types of area where you can work and excel as a police officer. For example, there are a lot of cyber crime coming up and there are a lot of new areas to explore in policing. And traffic is going to be one of the biggest challenge for any Indian city for that matter. So work profile in a place like Tamil Nadu will be larger and it will be multilateral rather than a northeastern state where the work is more focused on unilateral issues like insurgency and fighting the insurgents. For the question, who should opt for IPS, as per my opinion and my views, I would state that first of all, the person should be a very mentally strong person. Policing is not a cakewalk and it's not for everybody. Police officers are not born, they are trained. But even after the training, one should have the mental grit and the capability to handle the day-to-day issues, because you are working for the public and your work is very, very challenging and it's very, very varied. And essentially it involves the community and the public who you serve. So the work is not like armed forces where the enemy is known and the action what you take on the enemy is very, very standardized. But here there is no standard protocol, because every issue is very different and the take and the action or the what kind of thing you are going to do for it will be very, very different. That wise, a person has to be a very thinking oriented person with a small humane touch, because essentially the police is not the British police. We are Indian police now, and our motto is to serve the public. But to serve the public in a better way and in a more efficient manner, you also have to think what is the needs of the public and where your service orientation should be. So the person basically should have a tinge of humanity in him and also a faith in the system to serve public in the honest way, and also the person who has to follow rules and laws. So any person who has these kind of qualities and who has thinks that he can definitely bring the change what he wants to see in the society should certainly opt for police. Though it's a challenging career, it's a very rewarding and it's a very satisfying and it's a very, very noble profession, is what I say. But you should not only think that you may lack these qualities, but certainly you can improve these qualities. The only thing is you should have faith in yourself and believe in yourself that you can be a good police officer. Uh, There are many defining moments in a police officer's career, especially when the public, for who you work, they acknowledge your work and they convey their heartfelt gratitude and thanks to you. One such incident, there was a small kidnapping case where a 65-year-old man who is a very influential person in the society, belonging to a minority community, was kidnapped by some gangsters. We were able to track him, locate him and recover him in a matter of 5 hours. It was a very sensational case which was appreciated by many people. But after the recovery of that person, when I just was inquiring about his well-being, he was very thanks and he had conveyed a lot of his heartfelt gratitude to me. And in one moment he told, "Sir, I believe in my God, the God who I pray. But for this moment, you and your police department is the God for me." There is a lot of meaning to it, because I may essentially not be a God, but for that moment, he had felt he had seen God in us. So that kind of restoring the faith in the common man and making sure that yes, the police are there to protect and safeguard the innocent citizens from culprits. And it also gives you a feeling that yes, the justice system is working. So that kind of moments are the real defining moments in the police officer's career. I can say n number of stories like this, but this is one case, a live incident which had happened, which I just narrated to you. This, I feel, this kind of incidents make you feel the job satisfaction, and also to feel that yes, you have done something to somebody who is in need. My suggestions and a few points for any essential UPSC Civil Services aspirant would be, first of all, to have faith in yourself and belief in yourself. As any human being, if you have the quality of believing in yourself, you will develop the self-confidence and also you will have the mental courage to take on this exam. Because preparing for the UPSC exam, civil services exam, is not an easy joke, and it's not it's easier said than done. So first of all, you have to go through a grueling process of classes, the vast syllabus, and you have to write a lot of tests. So it's nearly a year-long process where you have to prepare yourself both physically and mentally to crack this exam. So the first, as I said, the belief in yourself, which I believe strongly will take you to places, should be the essential quality of any civil service aspirant. And number two, one should have patience. One should have patience, because as said by people, a room is not built in one day. So great things take time to achieve are built, or whatever you may call it. So you should have patience and you should slowly prepare yourself. Another third point what I would like to say is, there is a saying that the more you fight in peace, or prepare or train in peace, the less you bleed in war. So you should consider the training time and the preparation time for the civil service exam like a war situation. You have to train yourself in what way the best possible, in one attempt can I crack this exam. And you should know the nitty-gritties, where you will where you have to concentrate and where you can fail or where you can succeed. So that kind of thing is very much needed in any civil service aspirant to undergo this grueling process of preparing for the UPSC exam. And next, you should be regular, consistent in your preparation. Make sure that you are reading regularly and you are revising the parts, and you should write tests in more number, so that you are improving your answer writing capabilities and the way you present your answer. Then essential qualities for a civil service aspirant, there is n number of qualities I can keep on saying, but essentially what I said, that like believing in yourself, being patient, having a strategy, and also to know the nitty-gritties, and also to prepare yourself mentally, and also more importantly, you should have a perfect balance of your preparation. I have seen people spending more of time in studies, then after some time they get burnout and they stop studying for a long. That should not be the case. You develop your work-life balance from the training preparation days for exam, so that you are having a standard thing of what to study, how long to study, and when I'm going to take a break, and how I'm going to write the test, and when I'm going to have my own set of hobbies. So you should be a balanced and a complete person to be a civil service aspirant. So these are the few qualities which I think is needed for a civil service aspirant to crack the exam, that too in a first attempt. My my tips for candidates appearing in civil services interview would be to be straightforward and always present yourself. Don't try to fake and don't try to get into an opinion that you can easily cheat the people of what not you are. Try to be very, very genuine and always try to be very strong in your conveying your message, what you want to say. Being strong doesn't essentially mean that you should get into arguments or being a little argumentative. One has to be assertive and firm, but he can be polite. So conveying the message of what you want to say for a particular question as an answer should be very, very crisp and it should be very, very simple. Don't use words which you don't know and don't mince words, especially trying to go for long sentences and trying to unnecessarily give a different meaning to what you wanted to convey. And second would be always to have opinions in a very neutral, in a very balanced and in a very, very common way and not as a very eccentric person, and you should not give an opinion which doesn't fit into the general thought process. It doesn't mean that you cannot, you have to essentially be a conformist, but yes, your opinions and should not be very, very eccentric in a way that it should be, it can be utopian or it is essentially overthrowing the system. Because what they see as a candidate coming for interview mainly would be how fit this person would be as a civil servant, providing the main his work profile and satisfying his duties to the public and to the government and to the constitution of India. So that way you should try, you should be a person who can work in the system and bring the much needed reforms and change. And you need not be a person who tries to question the system and who doesn't have faith in the system. So first of all, you should give a opinion and should give a picture that yes, I'm here to appear in the interview to give a opinion about myself, that I will be a best fit for this job. Also, not only as a candidate, but in the future as an officer, you will be serving the public with the most important ideals and principles, what the Constitution of India has said to us, and also a person who firmly believes that he can bring about change in the provided means and the, what under the law says. So as a candidate appearing for the interview, you should be first of all having a proper orientation of why you are going for interview, that is to get the service what you want and not to get into unnecessary argument or unnecessary some kind of feud with the interview panel. As an engineering student, basically, when I entered the civil services preparation, I had a lot of thoughts of what optional to choose and how to go about this exam. When I heard about the various optionals available for the candidates, I had cornered down on few optionals, and sociology was one among them. Then I came to know about Smart Leaders and the faculty and the main coordinator, Mr. Shivraj Vail sir. He was very good in making me understand about sociology, how it is an optional and how good it can fetch you marks, and how it is also rewarding as a civil servant to know about the society in which for which you're going to work. So taking sociology as an optional has envisioned me and has broadened my vision as a police officer and a serving civil servant. The coaching which in Smart Leaders given to me in sociology as an optional was excellent, and it was also more instrumental in me getting a very good mark in my optionals so that I can land in the service which I wanted and also in the rank which I can get. So sociology as an optional is a very good optional, and Smart Leaders is an institute which is a very thorough professional in the area of sociology and make you get very good marks and also improve your knowledge in sociology.